Have you created an AI agent with Jotform? Well, let me show you how you can use it with Salesforce. Hey, Jotformers, welcome back. I'm Kimberly. And like I mentioned, if you have created an AI chatbot or an AI agent with Jotform, you can absolutely utilize it with Salesforce. So as you can see, I'm currently in my desktop version of my workspace. And as of right now, I only have my AI agents chosen. So for this example, I'm just going to use Lana. She is a brand new agent. So let's go ahead and edit our agent. Now, as of right now, it's going to automatically populate me in the Salesforce channel, but if you're doing this at a later time, just make sure you navigate to that channel over on the left-hand side. So as of right now, we can easily choose to connect to Salesforce, but there is another way that you can do that. So I want to show that to you now. So I'm going to jump up here to publish. And again, it already has me in the Salesforce agent channel. So again, if it doesn't populate you there, just look for the Salesforce agent over here on the left. So from here, we get to choose, do we want production or sandbox mode? You get to choose that. So let's choose production. I'll do connect to Salesforce. We're going to go ahead and log in. And here we have some predefined skill sets to choose from. So you can see lead management, case management, and you can see on each one of these, it already has actions and articles set up. So if you want to save yourself time, consider this kind of like a template option. So I'm going to look at case management for this one. So we have 6 actions. So you can see all that it has right here. And then we have some articles that it is pulling from my Salesforce knowledge articles. But if you want to start from scratch, you can absolutely do that by clicking right down here. It's going to have no actions and no articles. So your best bet to save you some time is to choose one of these predefined ones. So I'm going to do the case management one. And you can see it is crafting our Salesforce agent, gathering the relevant knowledge, creating tools for our selected use case, and just putting those finishing touches. So we can see here, we have the actions and the knowledge. So if I click on actions, again, we see all of the ones that it's already populated. So if I need to see action logs for these, we can do that here. We can edit, rename, disable, or delete any of them. If we want to add additional ones, all we have to do is add a new action. And of course, we get to scroll through here, choose which action, choose the Salesforce object, and then let it know when it should run. And then similarly, we can head back to our knowledge. This is going to pull from, again, our Salesforce knowledge articles. So we can choose here. We can look at the summary. We can see that it's been crawled. We can manually recrawl. Maybe we've updated something. We can come here and manually do that, or we can delete an article altogether. Now, if you started from scratch, when you come to add a new knowledge, this is what it's going to look like. So you can search for a specific article, and we can even filter by FAQ, procedure, draft, or published. Because all of mine are chosen, it's not going to pull anything here, but this is what you'll see if you do start from scratch. All right, let's go ahead and give this a test. I'm going to come here to preview. And let's see what it says about learning about account password reset. So we can see it's searching that knowledge. And then it shows us how to reset our password. Perfect. All right, let's jump out of preview. I am going to come to my share agent and I'm going to copy this link. And now let's talk about how to get it added to our Salesforce Experience Cloud site. The first we want to make sure is we have an updated Jotform app from the App Exchange. This is going to allow us to access the chatbot option. So if I come over to my Experience Builder, and of course on the left-hand side, we already have components chosen. If I come down here, we see our Jotform AI chatbot. So we can click and drag this into the content header, and we see that pane open up on the right-hand side. Now the very top one is the agent URL, and that is what I copied just a minute ago from the publish tab. So I'm just going to paste that in right here. We get to choose if we want it to be on the right or the left. Let's update this so that way it puts it there. Perfect. Let's put it back on the right. We also see the greeting. Hi, how can I assist you? If we want to change what that looks like, what that says, we can do that here. And we can also change when it opens. We want it to open automatically, have it always open, or open after a certain amount of time. All right, this is good to go. Let's go ahead and publish and publish again. Perfect. All right, let's take a preview. And we see right down here, we have Lana, our AI agent, ready to go. And it really is as simple as that. If you have any questions about how to use your Salesforce agent, let us know down below in the comments. If you like this video and you got some value, hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe and turn on the bell so you get a notification every time we put out a new video. I'll see you next time.